Hello. In this part, we'll see how to connect the speakers using RDNet. First of all, we have to connect a controller in order to link the RDNet software to the speakers. We have two kinds of controllers available: the Control 2 with USB connectivity and Control 8 with both USB and LAN TCP/IP connectivity to the computer. Control 2 and Control 8 have respectively 2 and 8 RDNet output. It is possible to connect up to 32 devices in each port in daisy chain. When using the Control 8 via TCP/IP to a dedicated switch, we could link up to 20 Control 8 to a single computer. Let's go to the software interface. Press controllers in the toolbar and the controllers page will open. Connect our Control 8 with an USB cable. It will be automatically recognized and matched with our workspace. In most cases, the connection using Ethernet is more suitable because it allows to place the Control 8 on the stage, controlling the system directly from the front of house via Ethernet. The USB cable cannot be longer than 4 meters to work properly, while the Cat5 cable can be up to 100 meters long. Moreover, being the protocol the TCP/IP, we can use a wireless switch as well. Just the first time, if our goal is working via Ethernet, we have to set some network parameters in the Control 8. By pressing the Net button, it is possible to change the name and the network settings. Normally, we use the Control 8 with a fixed IP address. For instance, let's type 192.168.10.10 and press Send. Now the IP address is fixed and the name is given. Working with a fixed IP and plug directly the cable from the computer to the controller obliges to set a fixed IP address in the network card of the PC as well. Also, using a wireless switch with DHCP enabled is more common to set the switch network setting in a range of addresses in the same subnet of the one given at the controller in order to have the possibility to work both with DHCP or fixed IP. Our Control 8 is placed on the stage with a wireless switch connected to its Ethernet control port. The left and right clusters will be connected to the output 1 and 2 and the subs to the output 3 of the controller. The modules of the cluster will be wired in daisy chain starting from the top. The subs will be connected starting from the front left one going to the right one, then to the back right to the back left to create a sort of open ring. Now we are ready to talk with the Control 8 via TCP/IP, connecting the PC to the proper wireless LAN created by the switch on the stage. For more details about connection and controllers, refer to the manuals that can be found in the dedicated web page. That's all about connection. Thank you for watching.